The Cavs have now officially beaten the Celtics, and LeBron James and James Jones are on their way to their 7th straight NBA Finals. I haven't done a prediction like this since the start of the season when my video quality was, well, let's just say it wasn't up to top standard. I will look over what both teams have as strengths and weaknesses, what player needs to step up, and the key to success, every little detail. So, let's begin. I would like to give credit to Dom2K for the following images. Let's begin with playoff statistics. As you can see, the Warriors and Cavaliers share their playoff field goal percentages, and they are both very high. The Cavs lead the playoffs in 3-point percentage, which is a surprising factor. The Warriors are very well known for their 3-ball dominance, and if the Cavs can keep that up going into the finals, then this would definitely improve their chances of repeating. The Cavs have the 4th defensive rating, which is a big step up from the regular season. They used to have the 22nd ranking, and now they have the 4th out of the 16. But the Warriors still have the 1st thanks to Draymond stepping up a lot and controlling his temper. Not to say he is the only man helping the Warriors on defense, but he certainly is the main factor on this end. Both teams have the top 2 offensive rankings and aren't separated by much, but the way LeBron has stepped up to the plate recently is certainly going to give the Cavs some hope. Still on LeBron, he has got 32 points over the course of the postseason, which is just a phenomenal stat. Kyrie and Kevin Love have both lived in the Kings' shadow throughout the playoffs so far, but are contributing well enough. If you want to continue reading the stats, pause the video, but I'm moving on to the Warriors. Curry and KD are going to be the first two players in history to be going into an NBA Finals, both averaging above 25 points per game, whilst averaging over 50% from the field as players, so Cleveland have got some defensive issues there. As I said earlier, Draymond Green is doing a fantastic job down the defensive end, as he has 2 blocks and 2 steals a night. On the offensive end, he is still doing a fantastic job with 14 points and 7 assists, and for someone of his offensive value, that's pretty nice. As you can see, there are stats highlighted yellow for Thompson, which moves me on to my next point. Players that need to step up. For the Warriors, it's gotta be Klay. The last couple of years, Curry and himself were known as the Splash Bros, but now I see one splash guy and one brick. Out of the big 4, Klay has been averaging only 38% from the field and 36% from 3. He's only averaging 14 points a night and he's barely touching the ball. I know Thompson very well as a streaky player. One night I see him lining it up, and that is really going to be a big X factor against the Cavs, because if he isn't shooting well, then chances are Cleveland is going to take advantage of that. Now for the Cavs, I see Kevin Love has to step up. Not that he isn't exceeding well enough now, I mean, he has been averaging a double-double, but his defensive impact needs to be stronger. Sometimes the Cavs let LeBron do all the work, which sometimes works out, like in Game 5 against Boston, but sometimes it has been costly, like in Game 3 of the Eastern Conference Finals. Yes, he had a great Game 7, but do you remember when he was getting criticized by the media in the opening 5 games of the 2016 NBA Finals? This has really been an up and down season for Love, as he has had a lot of back and troubles and knee surgery. He is sort of like Klay as I see it, because he does extremely well in one game and not so good the next. For both of these players, it's pretty simple. This is the NBA Finals and you cannot slack off, especially if you look at the team you are against. For the Cavaliers, the key to winning this series is defense. LeBron, Kyrie, Kevin Love, everyone on the Cavs roster needs to step up in this section of the game. If LeBron can shut down Durant and Kyrie can shut down Curry, then this series will be way easier for the Cavs. For Golden State, well, it's clear what they need to do, and that is do what they have just done for the past 7 months. I see barely any faults in this system and see barely anything going wrong. In conclusion, both teams are coming out of the best playoff performances in the history of the NBA, and both want this ring badly. For LeBron, it's about legacy, and for the Warriors, it's about redemption after the blowing of a 3-1 lead. I hate to say this, but the Warriors win this series in 5. I would love to see this being more competitive, but I can't. The Warriors are too strong with KD. Golden State have too much firepower to make this more interesting. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would love it if you would leave your thoughts on the topic in the comment section below. I would like to again thank Dom2K so much for the images. A shout out to my boy BNS, he makes fantastic NBA content, so go sub. If you are new, I am a basketball channel where I make videos like these, team analysis videos, top 5s, anything NBA, you've come to the right place. Thanks again for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And peace out, my friends.